Hello everyone, I'm Rich Lamont, welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time here, welcome. I started this channel to share my love of salmon flies and fly tying. I cover everything from spey flies to salmon flies to artistic flies. I cover techniques. All my flies are step by step, so that way you can follow along. I try to give as much detail and specifics as I can throughout the whole process. That way it's much easier to understand, but you can also try out certain techniques and see certain things that I do. If there's anything that you ever need to know, or you have a specific question, by all means, shoot me a message. I'd be happy to make a video about it. Mondays, I'll be doing material reviews, everything from all the different pheasants that we use to different hooks, different threads and silks, tinsels, and more things that are used in salmon flies. So, if you guys enjoy the channel and you like a specific video, by all means, please hit the thumbs up button. If you're not subscribed, think about subscribing. That helps out the channel. That helps me out. And leave your notification bell on. That'll let you know when I post a new video, and you'll be able to follow along before anybody else. So with that being said, hope you guys enjoy this video. Let's get on with it. All right, so the hook that we're tying with today is a Byron Bjerke William Bartlett size 6-0. Absolutely beautiful hook, as are all of Byron's hooks. So here's his info. If you're interested, contact him and he'll get you sorted out. All right, so the pattern that I'm doing today is the Kate. I've done this one before. I did it more as a kit fly, though, versus my own interpretation of how I feel this fly should look. I'm doing this on a large hook. It is going to get framed. It's for my friend's wife. She's really deserving of it. And her name is Kate, so I kind of figured it would be really fitting. So, yeah, so it looks like you guys got the one more before the new year. And I'm happy to do this one. This one's going to be a bit fun. All right, so first we're going to start off with silver tinsel, and this is going to be small Vivus. I'll get you that label in just a second. That's got the model number right on there. Just do three turns back there, and then the tag is yellow silk. Thank you.
I'm not quite happy with some of those thread wraps. Actually, ended about there and get the yellow silk tied in. Once again, I probably should have done white thread, but I seem to be having issues with my spool of white thread. Okay, so we'll tie that off and then we'll do a little quick burnishing. Make sure that I can get this to open how I want. Clip off the rest. And now we got to tie in the tail, but to tie in the tail we need a little bit more of a flat spot right here. Now, the tail I've chosen for this one is going to be more splayed out. It's going to be more open. This is going to be a very modern style of tying this fly. Like I've said in previous videos, I typically like to use a topping that fits the tail. But this one's just such a nice one for this tail. I think I like that. now I'm just going to flatten the rachis. So right at the tie-in point, I'm using my flat-nose pliers. My nose have no grip on the inside, they're completely flat. And we will just flatten out right here. When you flatten it, make sure you actually don't squeeze too hard, because if you do, you can wind up breaking the rachis. It has a pretty large tail. And just take it down just a little bit. I'm just going to add a little bit of wax to the base underneath it, just to kind of keep it in place. The next body segment up here is silk also. So I'm going to be cutting this short. See what I mean here in just a minute. I'll put a drop of saliva on there as well. The tail veiling is either a Cotinga or, in this case, I'm going to use a kingfisher. Just removing a little fluff. just a little bit more wax here. That's to hold the ostrich in place. Okay, so now you get your ostrich hurl and just take the very base of it where it attached to the actual rachis of the feather and you strip a little bit off of that quill. And then to wrap it properly, you'll pull it out towards you and you'll notice the shiny stem of the hurl will be pointed down. And then if you pull it straight up, you'll notice that that stem is facing forward, and that's how you want it. And you make your turns as tight and as close together as you possibly can. And just wet your finger a little bit. And then you can just kind of tease that back a little bit. Okay, the ribbing is flat silver tinsel, which for this I'm using Lagartin. It seems to be the only real flat tinsel I can find. So it's the flat silver Lagartin, and then large oval Vetus. And the hackle is a red hackle. But the red hackle will actually start at the second body segment. The first segment is just floss, and the second segment is all seal's fur. So we'll tie in the flat first, and then we'll tie in the oval. So we'll tie them in on the back side here. And now for the oval silver, it's a large enough tinsel that I'm going to strip away some of the sheathing on the outside, and that exposes the soft silk core that allows you to tie in and have it be much smoother at the tie-in point. All right, time to tie in the red silk. And then we'll just wrap this back to the butt, and then we'll wrap back forward. Okay. So the body hackle starts here. And what we're going to do is tie it in on the very top, right where that tensile crosses over. And as soon as that tensile crosses over, it'll pick up this bit of hackle. First, I'm going to strip away the fluff. All that fuzzy stuff at the base of the feather we don't use. Tip of the hackle right on top. Then we go into using seal's fur. When you're applying your seal's fur, make sure you twist in the same direction. It doesn't matter if it's clockwise or counterclockwise, just always in the same direction. I'm kind of a counterclockwise twister. If you go back and forth, you'll just wind up untwisting it and you'll wind up frustrated. You always go in the same direction. Thank you. Okay, now we can start with our flat tinsel. When you wrap this, you want to make sure that your second wrap of flat tinsel passes in front of that red hackle. Okay, now I bring up the silver oval. Again, you want to do the same thing. Get that to pass right in front of that right there, like this. Now we take the hackle. Just kind of begin to fold that back as you wrap it. Okay, so next is a yellow, but for this I'm going to actually use slapping. I want this to be a little bit on the thicker side. I do have a little bit in my scrap drawer, so I'm going to use that. Hopefully it's long enough. It's too long. So I'll just start a new feather. Basically, you want the fiber to line up with the length of the red hackle. Need a little more wax. This one's kind of a cross between a schlappen and a regular saddle. Thank you. All right, I think I can tame that later.